All right. Hi, everyone, and hi to people joining us on the live stream. So it's my pleasure to introduce the first of our science department seminar series for this academic year. This is something I've been working on with my colleague, Dr. Pope, and we're really excited that we're going to be having hopefully monthly, at least monthly seminars here, which is really exciting. And we wanted to kind of start a tradition where we have our first seminar, our first couple seminars in the fall come from our own Chatham faculty members. So it's really my my pleasure to introduce Dr. Ali.
Thank you, sir.
So Dr. Ali started here, I think, in 2012.
Correct.
You got your PhD in human anatomy.
Correct.
From Al Narain University.
Yeah.
In Iraq. And mm-hmm. you were an ER and trauma surgeon.
Mm-hmm.
And you were professor of human anatomy, I think, chair of human anatomy at Al Narain University, and has been at Chatham for 10 years. He's won teaching awards for his work teaching human anatomy and teaching our cadaver labs. So he's gonna give us his talk today. So thanks very much for joining us. And I guess I should also say thank you to the folks at IT, and thanks to everyone for coming. You know, we're trying to put this all together. And we're also learning, so I really appreciate everybody working with us and making this a success. And with that, Dr.
Thanks,
Ali.
Will. Thank you so much. Good afternoon, all. Thanks for having me today. I will go over something. I discussed something. Me and one of my former students, Danny. So if you are simple demo, your thumb, all of your hand, your thumb, and your pinky. Do like that, all of you. All of you, like that, oppose each other. Then flex it carefully. You see something is popping there. Some they have, some are not. Right, left, some they have, some they are not. A lot of variation in the human body, regarding the muscles, how they show up, their arrangement, their actions, that put me in something. COVID started virtual. I run for the software. That's no idea about anything mentioned about the variation. Nothing. So me in my lab, I do other things. I hire someone. He take photos, captured film, edit that, and broadcast to the students. This is what we call it, the virtual side effect of the software we use it. Nothing mentioned about the variation. Any MD, any surgeon, when he opened, no idea what's going on. But you open and see. What's that? How can I do that? In which way? So I have something during the dissection course in the school, in the summer courses, I figure out something. I have this muscle. Tensor fascia soralis. Next slide, please. So this back of your knee, we call it popliteal fossa. As you sit now, put your hand behind it, something bulging, extend, not flexed. Something is bulging. This is fat tissue, nothing. But inside it, a lot of structure. You can see the boundary, yes. Boundary of this fossa, and you can see thumb scales, nerve, a lot of structure there. Those are forming the boundary of the popliteal fossa. I have an important muscle on the medial side. I have these two semitendinosus membranosus, the name of the muscle, gain their name according to the shape or the attachment or the function. Three items, no more than that. On the lateral side, I have biceps femoris, two head femoris in the back of your thigh. Next, please. Then, so accessory muscle are rare anatomical variation. So extranumeral muscle, sometimes not missing, but there is an extra. They start primordium, split of the muscle, that during surgery you can potentially lead to accident amputation of the tendon. Accident amputation. When you chop the tendon, be careful. We need those muscles sometimes. When I am a junior, 19, 83, a Japanese surgeon, he resected the greater anatomy from your belly to put in the calf, cosmetic issue. But if you have another muscle there, it can survive. He can resect this muscle and transplant it down there. That one of these events that happened to me. So either the radiological or symptom, of course. It means that you are symptomless, no symptom, and you live normal, and you have extra muscle. In my life, during dissection of human cadavers, more than hundreds I dissect, a lot. Also, I do a lot of surgery. Big muscle in your chest, big major, totally absent. Agenesis of the muscle. No muscle at all, no muscle. And it has many side effects. How we can make the diagnosis about that. Next slide, please. So this is the growth, how it starts. Limbad observed 7 weeks of development of life. Our limb, upper, my thumb, laterally. My leg, my big toe, medially. It means something has happened. This is the rotation of the lower limb for bipedalism. If you work on 4, not good. On 2, you can run. Run from what? From predator. Yeah. We can run away with the involvement of our cerebral line. Next slide, please. So this is what you call this story. We call it Hansen's node signal release from retinoic acid, activate a lot of macromolecule peptides. I will not go over that. How to start the growth of each muscle and each segments. They form the limb bud. Now, it might be in there is the story how to start the variation or supernumerary, extranumerary muscle or agenesis at all. It might be from the beginning of those muscles. Next, please. Lateral plate of the mesoderm, the growth responsible for growth of a cartilage, bone tendon, and formation of the hamstring muscle. This is the way how it starts to form the hamstring back of your thigh. All the segment, we call it dermatome or myotome. Nerve, with its go to this side, they form what you call it, that segment. Nerve is so vital in your body. Nerve growth factor, give signal, grow, move. Without this nerve, no growth. It's rudimentary. There is something, but not activate. Next slide, please. Then, I have one of the article mentioned about this case report, which I like it. It looks fantastic. If you read carefully about that, what will happen? Physical exam revealed tenderness, swelling, and painful palpable mass covered by normal skin. Painful. Normal skin. Pain should be redness. Am I right? Cardinal signs, any inflammation, redness, loss of function, swelling, feverish, a lot. But this normal skin, that's the important thing. Then, in the medial popliteal region, toward medial side, in the popliteal area, diagnose muscle strain or tear of hamstring region. Next, please. Now, so the differential diagnosis of this mass, how we make the diagnosis about this abnormal finding. One, peroneal nerve in neuropathy on the lateral side, we have a nerve that goes downward to your leg, responsible for dorsiflex of your leg. We call it common foot or common peroneal. This nerve run in a tunnel. This is fibrous tunnel. It might be interrupted and cause pain. The 2-1 is muscle strain or tear in hamstring group. Tear, jumping, running, any exercise that might cause this one. Then apparent fusiform shape of the muscle. That what we find it in 2 cadavers. 2 years ago and last year. So we have 2 variants, which is unusual. 1 in 1,000,000. I think we are lucky, Chatham, to have those top bodies with variation. Unusual. Then first of all, soft tissue tumors. In this region, it's rare to find with aging. With the age of adolescence, you can see fibrosarcomas, or what we call a tumor of bone or soft tissue in the extremity. Finally, aneurysm, which is sac aneurysm, mass in the artery, dilatation, palpable mass. Easily you can palpate that and find it. It's easy to be treated and fixed. Abscesses, any abscesses, any inflammation, fever, and loss of function from just from the exam. Next, please. Then one of my student, my good student, she dissected this region and she told me, what's that, Dr. Ali? Go ahead, please.
So just to explain the dissection process a little bit, so we started just by making an incision from right below your hip down all the way to about mid-calf, which exposed the fascia and the adipose tissue just underneath there when you peel the skin back. After clearing away that fascia and the adipose tissue, we just separated each of the muscles, and that it would expose each of the heads of the biceps femoris, the semitendinosus, and all of the little things in the popliteal fossa, which would be like your popliteal artery, your popliteal vein, and your sciatic nerve. Upon doing this, we discovered that variant that Dr. Ali is talking about, and it stretched from the end of your biceps femoris long head all the way in between your gastrocnemius muscles, which are the two muscles that give you that like definition in your calf. And it was measuring about 120 millimeters in length and 18 millimeters in the width. And then after this, it's just pictures. You can probably explain them a little better.
Thanks, Danny. So what we have? CT MRI, simple. You can see lower end of the femur, upper end of the tibia, soft tissue. You can see there is something, two head of the gastrocnemius. This is medial head of the hamstring muscle, right, left. And there is a soft tissue there, very well localized and very well rounded. When they examine me for PhD degree, they show me something like that. I have no idea what's that, no idea. It's the biceps femoris in the back, but in a position, flexion. It's rounded, the muscle is rounded. I thought it's a mass. So this is the finding, what we find. So you can see the two semi on the medial side, semitendinosus membranosus, and you can see the medial head of the gastrocnemius there, and you can see this massive tissue, a massive tissue. Next slide, please. So what we find, this in Chatham School, cadavers. Pincet structure. You can see one, two, three. Extraordinary, a lot of muscles running from back of the thigh downwards. And this is the calf muscle, two head of gastrocnemius. Those three muscles create a massive structure. When you dissect, my student, they dissect that, it not pops fast, no, it need time. Towel, wipe it with the towel, leave it for 5 minutes. Little bit dry, it will show the muscle fibers, which is unusual. Those muscle fibers, you can make measurements about the next one, please. And direction, this for the last year, a couple years ago. We see that a muscle starts from the thigh downward, crossing the knee. This muscle is an extension from biceps femoris or from the two semi. This is from semitendinosus and membranosus, which is very rare variation. Next slide. Now we start to do these measurements. So the length, the width of the muscle, and it's a good reservoir. We can resect those muscles for transplants. Anywhere we can need it. That's good for that. So the lateral side, and this is the medial side, tendon of semitendinosus. It comes from biceps femoris. We are in the process of make calculation, and we make sort of because of this variation, how we can use it clinically. Next, I think the last one, this one. This is the width of the muscle. There is a sort of calculation about the length and width of the muscle. We can use it as grafting. Either if it's so tiny and small, we neglect that. Those has an effect, especially in physical exercise. When you are running and there is a mass, there is a painful posterior to your knee. This might be traumatized for those unusual location of the muscle. So I think the last one is that. This is the reference and we work on this project, me and Danny. Thank you so much for having me. That's what I have. I am ready for any question. Yes, ma'am.
So what was the prognosis for the 18-year-old long jumper?
Oh, that's just a sec that they remove it.
Oh.
They remove the muscle and he's good to go back home. No need to do anything. Yeah, there is something. In medical practice, two things. The money, health. You should choose either the money or the health. You can do physical therapy, do many things, but simple thing, chop the muscle, go back home. Done. Yeah, that's, now there's a trouble about the hernia repair. They use mesh, correct? For hernia repair, mesh, mesh, mesh. Simple and easy. Take fascia lata from lateral side of your thigh, or resect one of the muscle in the leg, plantaris, tendon like that. No need for that, vestigial muscle, suture. Go back home. But money. Yes? Yes, Lisa.
Do any particular sports tend to be associated with variants that you were aware of? Like, does somebody with shorter femurs go be more successful in one sport or another? Are any of these variations associated with good things, like success in a particular field?
Oh, that's a great question. You have a reservoir in our body. We can resect what we like. So those extra number of muscle, we can use them. Regarding the sport exercise, each one, this is come from the gene coding, from the gene, how it's happened. Extra number, we have no idea. All of us in this classroom, we have our sacrum, 5 segments. Sometime fusion of the last number, we call it sacralization of L5. We live normally, nothing else. Accidentally, an X-ray, you see that. Let me tell you something. Laparotomy, at time Iraq-Iranian war. Right kidney, totally damaged, fragmented. So let me resect it, get rid of that. Something in my head, they told me that. Put your hand to the left kidney, check the left kidney. I put my hand, there is no left kidney. Agenesis. Right is totally damaged. Left, no. Agenesis, no kidney, which usually happen. Let me go back to the right kidney. No need to resect that. 3 hours, piece by piece, piece by piece. Little bit, little bit. After the anesthetist, hey, Ali, what you are doing? Increase the blood pressure, let me check. I just look under the theater table. There is urine with the blood. Got it. Working. Unusual. And at the time in Iraq, when they recruit for the war with Iran, no exam. And you live normally, one kidney normally. Normal. And when you transplant the kidney, they put it in the pelvis, not in the normal location. It goes down.
Have you ever seen any cervical ribs?
A lot. When they come with the pinky complain, cervical rib. Paresthesia, numbness in that side. Sometimes it becomes a bone, you can see it on X-ray. Sometimes it's soft, your cartilage. You cannot see it. Easily to be resected after that, you are good to go. Better than go to the physical therapist and massaging, and no. Just remove it. Yes?
I'm just curious, you said these anatomical variants should be like 1 in 1,000,000, and you saw 2 of them.
According to the location, according to the sites. In many articles, they cited that this variation about the muscle in the hamstring, 1 in 1,000,000. Yeah, mentioned that. They mentioned. Other variation, no, a lot of variation. Especially the arterial supply of the gut. In the GI tract, when you are doing surgery on the greater mesentery or stuff, a lot of variation. You can see that. It's easy. Yes.
The variation in those sort of organs, is that?
The organ is.
Is that from birth as well, or is that from?
From birth.
Or can that variation just happen?
No, from birth. From birth. We call it dextrocardia. Your heart on the left side, it's on the right side. Appendix become on the left side. We call it dextrocardia, all organ shifting of that. Usually that's sometimes confusing for the surgeon, always, always. For that reason, thanks Lisa, 2020, when we push the summer course to the end of the summer dissection course. So they have idea about that. Any virtual, any software for anatomy, advanced anatomy, precisely, not work with the software. A lot of variation, a lot. Yes? Any question?
So with the project and moving forward,
we make
the cadavers you have right now, right?
We have right now, we're doing the make the calculation. The former one will push it towards Virginia to their home. We already have the measurements for that. Yeah. I collect materials. You can see that the new neuroscience guys, I collect more than 30 cerebral lines. I'm interested in the cerebellum. Yes.
So when you make these measurements, is the absolute value what's important, or do you then relate it to some other sort of standard measure?
We compare with the other measurements of the Chinese or Japanese. I'm not sure about that it to be worth this one, we can resect it.
You do it, you have a standard of another muscle.
Another muscle for that. It's big, massive, it crosses the joint.
Usually the standard that doesn't vary.
A lot of in your body. But something is crossing your knee in the back. That's bad. Ugly in shape sometimes. Yes? Thank you so much for having me. Appreciate it.